Good morning to everyone. Hello, good morning to everyone.
Very good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, sir.
Good morning. Thank you for being here.
Good morning, sir.
Salutations to you from Nitesh School of Management. Thanks for joining this very important day. In fact, the day of the day on the part of Nitesh School of Management. Today, we are going to inaugurate the 12th batch of a prestigious PGD and there is postgraduate diploma in management. I welcome each one of you in just one word and I'll come back to later. And before we start anything, you know, our tradition goes that we should pray because prayer is the only way to connect ourselves. Prayer is power, prayer is beautiful. May I request my colleagues Kashmi, Gautami and Surya to join us for the prayer.
शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशमये गजमुखने गणपतिये निनगे वंदने नम्बिदवर पालिना कल्पतरुणीये गजमुखने गणपतिये निनगे वंदने नम्बिदवर पालिना कल्पतरुणीये
Kashmi, Gautami and Surya for that soulful rendering. There's a saying, we can pray when you choose to, but we can always remain prayerful lifetime. Therefore, nothing prevents us from being prayerful, including this particular event. Now it's my proud privilege to extend my hearty welcome to each one of you. At the outset, let me heartily welcome on behalf of Nitte Group of Institutions and Nitte School of Management, Dr. Nagaraj Ramarao, Vice Chancellor, Kalasulingam Academy of Research and Higher Education, who will be our chief guest this day. Welcome to you, sir. I take this opportunity to welcome Sri Annamalai IPS and presently the most powerful motivational speaker, the most sought after writer, man with a lot of passion and pursuit, and he will be our guest of honor today. Welcome to you, Sri Annamalai, sir. The president of Nitte Education Trust and the chancellor of Nitte University, he is our karta of this entire group. Seeking blessings of Sri N. Vinay Hegde, welcome to you, sir. We seek your blessings. I welcome Dr. Professor N.R. Shetty, the chief mentor of this Nitte campus, two times the chancellor of Bangalore University, and world-known expert in higher education. Thank you, sir. It is your benevolence that we are with. So you are welcome, sir. I welcome Sri Rohit Punja, the administrator of entire group of Nitte, that is Nitte Education Trust, who will also give a presidential address at the latter part. Welcome to Sri Rohit Punja, sir. I welcome heartily Dr. S.C. Nagaraj, the principal of Nitte Meenakshi Institute of Technology, one of the most reputed institutes of the country for reasons more than one. And he is heading this institute as a principal. On behalf of all of us here, I welcome Dr. Nagaraj to this function. And little while later, he is going to light the lamp and inaugurate program. Dr. Nagaraj is a man with heart, golden heart. He is the one, you know, who's always heart reaches to everyone whoever in need. Thank you, Dr. Nagaraj, sir, for being with us, and we'll be back with you for the next item. Let me thank our illustrious director of this institute, Dr. M. Venugopal. For reasons beyond his control, he could not be here, but he's little outside the Bangalore for a very personal reason. Dr. Venugopal is the one who is the torch bearer in the last one year or so. He has transformed the institute into a very viable management institute in terms of admissions, in terms of placement, and in terms of bonhomie and goodwill. Welcome to you, Dr. N. Venugopal. We wish we were here, but sooner than later, you are going to be with us physically when the students join us physically. Thank you, sir, and welcome to you, sir. It is my privilege to thank profusely Professor Karunakar Rai, the professor in the NMIT here, who is instrumental in getting the guest today. I also welcome Sri Bharatadri, who is the face of the entire Nitte group in terms of publicity, giving publicity, in terms of image building, and he is a kind of a bridge between the Nitte group and the world outside. Bharatadri sir, we are very happy that you are here physically at this point of time. A big welcome to you. Let me also welcome Dr. Ramachandra, the head of HOD of ENC to this. I would like to welcome our esteemed guest faculty of this organization who form the very strong backbone in terms of teaching. We have a very teaching lineup, which you'll see a little later through a PPT. I specifically and specially welcome Professor Ranganath Iyengar, Professor Anala Padmanabh, Professor Atul Sharma, Professor Giri Narayan, and all other guest faculty who are with us. I should welcome all my colleagues all the HODs of this campus, welcome you, sir, for this program. Now, may I request Dr. S.C. Nagaraj, the principal of NITTE NMIT, to kindly light the lamp and light our hearts too. Please come, sir.
I also request Dr. Karunakar Rai, Professor NMIT, Dr. Ramachandra AC, HOD, Department of Electronics and Communication, Sri Bharatadri, Media Officer NMIT, and Dr. N. Jayarama Shetty to join with Dr. H. C. Nagaraj sir to light the lamp.
Let us honor our guests here with a bouquet. May I request Professor Kishore Kumar to offer a bouquet to Dr. Nagaraj. Kishore Kumar ji, hi. Yes, newly joined, sir. May I request Professor Richard ji to offer a bouquet to Professor Ramachandra Chodi, PhD. You can go there. Yeah. Please come, sir. Please. Thank you. Thank
फॉर्मल
Thank you, sirs, for accepting this bouquet. It is just a symbol of our affection, a kind of gratitude. Now, it's my privilege to request Dr. C. Nagaraj to give his inaugural address at this point of time. Sir, please come.
Good morning. Our respected President of NITI Education Trust and also Chancellor of NITI University, Sri Vinay Hegde sir, our advisor, Professor N.R. Shetty, former Vice Chancellor of Bangalore University for 2 terms, and also the Chancellor of Central University of Karnataka, Kalburgi, our Administrator, Sri Rohit Punja, the Director of NITI School of Management, Dr. Venugopal, who is not here today because of some personal problems, Dr. Jairam Shetty, our colleagues, Dr. Karnakarai, Dr. Ramchandra, Mr. Bharatadri, and all my dear respected faculty members of NITI School of Management. The chief guest of today's program, Dr. Nagaraj R., who is my old friend. Now at present, he is the Vice Chancellor of Kalasalingam University. And also the guest of honor, Sri Annamalai sir, who is a motivational speaker, who has already addressed our students of NITI Meenakshi Institute of Technology earlier also, who is the guest of honor for today's inaugural program. And all the invitees of the principals of our sister institutes in Bangalore and other campuses, and my dear student friends, that is new students who have joined our NITI School of Management, and also the respected parents and guardians of these new students. I'm very happy that our sister institute, NITI School of Management, has initiated this inaugural program of 12th batch of PGDM, Postgraduate Diploma in Management program, which is a 2 years program after graduation. And this institute is an autonomous institution approved by All India Council for Technical Education, New Delhi. And it is headed by Dr. Venugopal, the director of this institute. First of all, on behalf of the management of NITI Education Trust, I cordially welcome all the new students, the first year students who have taken admission for the student 2021 academic year. I welcome all of you for this institute, and I also welcome all of you to join the NITI family, because always we used to say that any student or any staff who joins our NITI Education Trust, we say that you are joining our NITI family. NITI is the name of a place near Karkala, about 8 kilometers from Karkala. It is the birthplace of Meenakshi Hegde, the wife of our founder, Justice K.S. Hegde. So Justice K.S. Hegde was the Judge of Supreme Court of India. He started small school in 1979 at the birthplace of his wife, Meenakshi Hegde. That is the village NITI. NITI is not an abbreviation, it is a name of a village. Now, under the presidentship of Sri Vinay Hegde sir, we are having 3 different campuses. One in NITI village, where we are having our engineering college, which was started in 1986, polytechnic school, degree college. And the other campus is in Mangalore, where we are having NITI deemed to be university. We are also having medical college, dental college, pharmacy college, nursing college, like that. And we are having 12 satellite medical centers.
Broadcasting campus,
where we are having NITI Meenakshi Technology, School of Architecture, Fashion Technology. We are having Pharmaceutical Institute, and this our sister institute, NITI School of Management. We are having international school, PU colleges, degree colleges. So 3 campuses under the umbrella of NITI Education Trust. So I'm very happy that you have taken admission in a reputed institution, which is having the very strong faculty members with very rich experience and qualification. The faculty members are the backbone for any institution. I'm proudly say that Nitya School of Management is very strong with very senior faculty members with varied experiences in industry, in banks, in academic institutions, and they are highly qualified also. And it is having very good infrastructure, very good internet connectivity, computers, books, etc. So all facilities are provided to our students to make them a very good citizens of our country and also industry ready. And this institute is an autonomous institution, and syllabus is being revised once in a year. And they are having on their board the CEO of Xerox and IIM professors are all there on the board of studies of this college. And a lot of Ragnath Iyengar, so many people, very rich people in academics and experience and qualifications there on the board and headed by Professor Enna Shetty, who is the chairman of this board of studies, governing council of this college. And they used to give us the valuable inputs to have the state-of-the-art technology, the syllabus. The syllabus should meet the industrial requirements and societal requirements. Our students be exposed to what is happening outside the world of the classroom. All these facilities, they'll be taken to industries, even they'll be taken to Singapore and some foreign countries to give better exposure for the students. So my appeal to all the new students is, you have joined a very good institution. Only thing is, from your side, you have to put in hard work. There is no substitute to hard work. You have to put in hard work. And always the patient goes to the doctor and not vice versa. So for any problem, patient will go to doctor. Doctor cannot go to the patient. Similarly, for any of your problem, academic problem or personal problem, you have to go to the teacher and mentor. Our teachers are all our mentors. Always they are here to help our children. They are here to help mold you. And you have to become finally the very good citizens of our nation. So all our teachers will help you. Both academical problems, they will solve your academic problems as well as personal problems, they will help you. So you have to go to teacher and not vice versa, like a patient going to doctor. And remember that for every problem, there is a solution. I used to give always an example of one lock, but there is a lock always. Any lock will be having one or two keys, even more than two keys also. There is no lock without a key. That means for every problem, there is a solution. It may be multiple solutions also, more than one. So one solution may be good in one way, other solution may be better in some other way like that. So all these will be, you'll be getting help from our teachers who are committed, who are dedicated faculty members. So always there will be problems will be there. Problems will come for human beings only, not for animals. So we should face the problem. Don't try to escape from the problem. And always there's a solution, one solution, more than one solution, optimal solution for any problem in the world. This you should bear in mind. And simple learning a bicycle, you may fall down in the race, bicycle ride. Even I fell down some 2-3 times without falling. I cannot, nobody has learned cycling. Similarly, car driving, whatever it may be. So you will fall, ups and downs will be there in the life. But once you get fall or when you get a bad score or something, the result or something, don't get frustrated. Always there's a chance for improvement. We have to improve day by day. We have to move towards improvement. Failures are the pillars of success. They are stepping stones to success. So once you fail, it doesn't mean that you are not good. God has given potential to everybody. One person will be good in English, one person will be good in music. But everybody will have one or the other talent. So you have to expose your talents and talk to seniors, talk to teachers, talk to elders, talk to your parents. Definitely you will get success. The only thing from your side, you should be regular to the classes and always put in hard work. There is no substitute to hard work. And other one is, the library is very good. You have to visit library, make use of the opportunity, you know, best facilities available in this institute, and internet connectivity, laboratory, computer lab, all these things are there. Subjects are of the latest technology, latest state of the art. So you have to make use of those things and learn things always. Knowledge is power. Learning is function of knowledge, skills and attitude. So knowledge is very important. Knowledge is power. There, you cannot get rid of knowledge. Knowledge is very, very important, and skills. So always now in this COVID time, pandemic, we have to take this as a challenge and opportunity for COVID. So a lot of reskilling is taking place. So reskilling is very, very important in this COVID time pandemic to overcome these things. So skills are very important. And third one is attitude. So we should have positive attitude always, learn things with good mind. So knowledge, skills, attitude, these three are very, very important. So I'm also, I thank all the parents and guardians for having their admitted their children to the one of the best institutions in Bangalore, where a lot of focus is given on the teaching learning curriculum, that is curriculum delivery, curriculum design, and also curriculum evaluation, that is assessment. All these things have been taken care here, and students, very good placement ratio is there. You need not worry. Only thing is students should be regular to the classes and they should put in hard work. With this, I welcome all our new students, fresh batch for this 2020-22 batch, that is 12th batch of our DTS School of Management. Also on behalf of the management, I'm very, very happy that Dr. Nagaraj, who is my old friend, who was the principal of Oxford College of Engineering, Bangalore, now he's the vice chancellor of Kalasalingam University. He is the chief guest. I also welcome him as well as also thank him on behalf of the management. I also thank our young dynamic Sri Annamalai sir, who is a motivational speaker, who has visited our Nittai Meenakshi Institute of Technology and addressed our students. Again, we request him to come and address our students for competitive examinations. So I once again, I welcome him as well as thank him on behalf of the management. So you have all the opportunities, please make use of the opportunity for our new students. And I declare this inauguration of this 12th batch of our PGTM students open today. And I wish all the best to all our young students. And I thank all my colleagues and director of NITI School of Management, and Dr. Jairam Shetty, and all the faculty, Bharatad, and all my colleagues for having come over here. So I thank all of them on behalf of the management. Once again, I wish you all the best. Thank you.
It was indeed so nice and gracious of you, Dr. S. C. Nagaraj, sir. For Nittai School of Management, Dr. Nagaraj, sir, is always just one word. Although he himself is heading such a big college with more than 5,000 students, you know, he's always at the call of the students. He's so kind. I'm not exaggerating. So kind. All the qualities of heart and head Dr. Nagaraj sir has. In fact, till last year, he was the research dean of one of the prestigious universities, that is VTU. And in my own research work, of course, tenure teachers, he always comes handy. Whenever in times of distress, you just go to his place and he's there to help us. Therefore, sir, even today, with just the shortest call, you came here and you talked here. In fact, you symbolize a lot of energy, a lot of motivation, and the life. And the message that you gave is really wonderful. I'm just kind of, someone asked the Lord Buddha at the end of this life, he said, can you put the life's message in three words? He's, you know, it's Ananda, the dearest, he asked, Lord, can you put the message in three words? He said, Asanam, Stiram, Sukham, only three words. Actually, this is like Aham Brahmasmi. Asana means find a place to be, like you have found a place here. It's a very vast concept. Find a place, either at the workplace or the domestic place or at the feet of the Lord. Find a place. Stiram means make it firm. Don't waver. That's what Dr. Nagaraj said. Once you take up the course, go to the beginning of beginning till the end of end. And then Lord said, when you take a asana, a position, and when you form yourself with a commitment, sukham, the happiness automatically flows. Therefore, friends, that same thing, taking the analogy here, you have come here and you have found a seat, and we will help you form yourself, and then lifelong sukha. Sukha means all those dreams will automatically follow. Thank you, Dr. Nagaraj, sir, for your nice address. We are really very happy to be having this. Thank you so much. Moving further, now the chief guest, Dr. Nagaraj Ram Roy is with us now. I will request Professor Richagi to kindly introduce Dr. Ram Rao.
Good morning, everybody on the virtual platform. Man is made by his belief. As he believes, so he is. And I distinctly remember Dr. Nagraj, sir, as one who believes in himself and instills this thing for his students. Professor Nagraj Ram Rao, an eminent academician, researcher, and an able administrator, is the Vice Chancellor of Kalasalingam Academy of Research and Education, Srivilliputtur, Tamil Nadu. Till recently, he was the Director of Dhirubhai Ambani Institute of Information and Communication Technology, Gandhinagar, Gujarat. Gujarat, a state private university, and also in charge director of IIIT Technology, Vadodara, Gujarat. In his career spanning over more than 30 years, he was a director and also principal of the Oxford College of Engineering, Bengaluru, and also served as professor and head of the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering there. Earlier, he was the professor and director of RV Center for Cognitive Technologies Research and Development Center under the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, RV College of Engineering, Bengaluru. He has also worked as assistant engineer in Karnataka Power Corporation Limited and has also served MSRIT, Bengaluru. A PhD from Visheshwarya Technological University, he also had several administrative assignments such as Board of Examiners and Board of Studies member for VTU, Bengaluru University, Manipal University, Mahe, etc. He has also contributed as principal investigator for various completed and ongoing DRDO research projects. He has published several research papers and articles in peer-reviewed journals and transactions. He has guided and still guiding several research scholars towards their PhD. He holds a bachelor's degree in electronics engineering from Bengaluru University and a master's in power electronics from Gulbarga University. He has also an independent director of Gujarat Informatics Limited. He is a recipient of Rashtriya Shikshana Samiti Award for Academic Excellence for the year 2006 and 2007. He is also a recipient of RV VLSI Mentorship Award from RV VLSI Design Center, Bengaluru. He was also a National Merit Scholar. He is a senior member of IEEE Fellow, Institute of Engineers India. Recent past chair to IEEE CIS Chapter, Gujarat Section. Life member of IETE, ISTE, and ACM, and Computer Society of India. He is a guest editor of Circuit World and a peer reviewer for various important international journals, transactions on fault tolerance and optimum control. I welcome you with all my heart and knowledge. Thank you for joining us, sir. Kindly, if you can take the dice.
Good morning, all of you. Namaskar. It's indeed a great pleasure and honor to be a part of this very important event, the inaugural function for the PGDM course offered by the BITES School of Management. Most revered Chancellor, sir, Sri Vinay Hegde, most respected Dr. N. R. Shetty, most respected again, Dr. H.C. Nagraj. I'm very fortunate he called me my friend, called me as his friend, but I see him as my guru. So thank you very much, sir, for introducing me and as your friend and guiding me at some part of time in my life when I was pursuing my research. Dr. Venugopal, my former colleague at the Oxford College of Engineering, the faculty of the School of Management, faculty of Nitya Meenakshi Institute of Technology, fellow colleagues, and most importantly, Mr. Annamalai, former IPS officer and the motivational speaker now, and fellow students who have chosen Nitya School of Management to pursue their master's degree in management. It's indeed a pleasure and honor to be one amongst you on this most important occasions of your life. I keep asking, what is the need for another degree when you already have one? You are already, all of you are already graduates. You hold a bachelor's degree, whatever may be the area of specialization. All of you are a graduate once. Now, what is the need for a master's? What is the need for a post-graduation? I keep asking myself as an educationist. See, during bachelor's, all of us would have gone through a specific course, and obviously the learning over the 4-year degree or a 3-year degree that you would have undertaken would be very peripheral and may not have gone into the depth of what actually knowledge means. But it is sufficient enough to get you a job. But the dearth for higher knowledge, dearth for getting into the deeper nuances of the area of specialization, one would like to pursue a master's course, and especially a master's course in management is what is looked for and what people would like to cherish upon when they think that they have leadership skills in them. A person who can overall take care of the functioning of the entire system, a person who can manage systems, a person who can steer the system to its designated outcomes is the one who takes up this particular course. And PGDM is very unique because most of the time you people would have already been in various jobs and definitely gained certain skills while pursuing those jobs, and then probably you felt that you need to hone your skills further and probably take yourself a little more forward, a little more ahead in terms of managing larger systems. And that's the reason you have got into this field of, a master's degree in management. And Nitya School of Management is one of the most sought after places for a course similar to what you have taken. It is very, very reputed organization, not only in state of Karnataka, but all over India. The rankings and the ratings that the Nitya Institute of Technology has been getting, and also the Nitya University, the standing the Nitya University has in the academic world is indeed, cherishable and the one which is leading light in the private education system in the state of Karnataka. So as Dr. Nagaraj sir put it up, you are all in safe hands with respect to the institute that you have chosen and also with respect to the profession that you would like to undertake after this degree. Now I keep asking again a similar question, why do you have to keep studying throughout your life? What do you mean by lifelong learning? What do you mean by life skills? And what is that you gain in joining a reputed institution like Nitya School of Management? It's quite obvious, all of us for that matter have gone through this. I always tell my students, there's something called as a shelf life for any graduate. Earlier, our days, the shelf life maybe could have been about 10, 15 years. Once graduate, you are employed for about 10, 15, 20 years. No government employments those days, but at least in the private sector, you are sure that if you are an engineer, if you are a professional graduate, you are employed for about 15, 20 years. Down the line now, past 20, 25 years, I've been, or 30 years, I've been into education system. I joined way back in 89 as a lecturer at MS Ramaiah Institute of Technology. So from that time, when I'm looking towards the way the education has evolved, the shelf life of any graduate has been reducing and reducing drastically in terms of the skill sets the world demands from these graduates. So what happens is, I keep telling my students, wherever I go, I say the shelf life now is hardly any year. So whatever you would have learned in the last 4 years of your graduation or 3 years of graduation would be sufficient enough, probably maybe with a bit of hands-on, it may be sufficient enough for you to get into your job. But sustaining in the job for years to come is definitely a challenge. This is where institutions like NITES School of Management play an important role in inculcating the lifelong learning skills in its students. There is no shortcuts. You have to be always abreast of what is happening around you, and there is no shortcuts for reading. Keep reading, not only into your areas of specialization, but you should read beyond the specializations and move forward. That is what is needed at the current situation. The new education policy, which has been put up by Government of India, also speaks volumes about training the students, training the children right from their maybe sixth or seventh standard onwards, wherein coding has been introduced. So the meaning of all this is obviously to inculcate in its students the zeal for learning and a zeal for continuous reading and continuous studying, and keeping you oneself updated about what is happening around us. India is, an intellectual economy. Though we are basically an agrarian economy, whatever India is today or whatever standing India has in the world today is basically because of the knowledge economy that India has produced for the last 60, 70 years of its existence. Knowledge basically is the intellectuals, people like you who have been graduating in large volumes and going around and going out of the country and serving in various capacities throughout the world. This is basically the reason for the USP of India, the reckoning for India being on the rise, not because of the, not maybe partially because of its economic growth, but I would say that economic growth basically has happened due to people like you, people who have been graduating, and all of us talk about the demographic dividend, all of us talk about the young population of this country, all of us talk about young India, wherein we say there are about 30 to 40 crore people of its total population, of its 130 crore population, there are about 40 or 50 crore people who are in their prime youth and who can contribute to the growth of the nation, not only India but also the world. So you are in that age group of contributing to the growth of the country, contributing to the growth of the world. As Dr. Nagaraj sir put it up, please make use of this opportunity. It's a great opportunity being provided to all of you in terms of getting into a very good institution, and also now it is your turn to make use of the intellectual resources available in this institution. It could be in terms of the teaching fraternity, or it could be in terms of the learning resources that is available in the institution. This pandemic has given this pandemic as an opportunity, because whatever wouldn't have been possible physically is possible now. I just can't imagine that I would have been in this function if I was at Madurai in my university, busy with some sort of the activity of the university. Just because we are all meeting virtually, the world has become really a global village in real terms. We are able to see each other, we are able to participate in all such events, in all such programs. And I see this pandemic as a great opportunity in terms of, breaking those technological barriers and making use of technology towards better imparting of education. The virtualism, online classes is the new norm. And as far as the plan would have been of the School of Management, it is quite obvious the classes would be online at least for some period of time till actually those restrictions on free movement is removed. So at least academics, as per the statutory bodies, it could be UGC or AICT, we don't see resuming physical operations as late as October. So you're starting now first second week of August, and maybe till October you would be functioning virtually. And this is a great opportunity to all of my friends, because you work from home, you attend those classes, but you are attending those classes at your comfort, and you have whatever you would like to do along with your regular classes. The sky is the limit. I when I started this talk, I asked you a simple question: why post graduation? And I also stressed upon continuous learning and lifelong learning. And I said there is no shortcuts. So keep reading and keep reading through whatever is relevant to you or may not even be relevant to you. I think Annamalai sir would definitely put it up in a better way, because he has seen the world in a different perspective. So definitely keep reading and keep increasing the horizons of your understanding of this world. And only when you understand the nuances, and then only you can be very good managers, because any manager should be as close to the society as possible. Any manager must be very sensitive about the sustainable environment, sustainable development that is going to happen around us. And let us all become responsible managers when something is thrusted upon us in terms of steering certain activities. So I would not take much time, because when people like Annamalai is there, who himself is known as a motivational speaker, definitely it is going to be difficult and different cup of tea for a person like me. Though we have been motivating throughout our lifetime thousands of students in terms of what is that they need to do once they get into any sort of professional education. Definitely people like Mr. Annamalai, who have seen the world in a different perspective, as I said earlier, would be able to motivate all of you in a better way. I sincerely thank the management of NITI School of Management, and in particular Dr. H.C. Nagaraj, who has graced this occasion today, and my former colleague Dr. Venugopal. Unfortunately, he is not with us today here due to various personal reasons probably. I thank him also profusely. I thank the entire management of the NITI School of Management for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this very important occasion in the lives of the students who are joining into the new batch of 2021. And also, I wish all the best to the new students who have joined this management program in this very good institution. Wish you all the best. I pray the Lord that the best would happen to you in terms of building your careers and nurturing your endeavors throughout your life. Thank you very much. Wish you all this. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nagaraj Ramram sir. It was in fact an excellent a kind of a speech of a scholarly talk. A professor talks and the world listens. The kind of message you put in at this juncture is very, very appropriate. You touched upon the COVID factors, the positivity part. As a true teacher, you sent that message here, nothing to be taken as a sad note. Everything is for good. Then excel, you touched upon the new education policy. In about span of 20 minutes, it was such an important speech. Probably We wish we could have you some other time in the campus physically. Thank you so much on behalf of Nitte Group of Institutions, the management, Dr. Sinag himself, who is a close friend. Thank you so much for being the chief guest and the kind of talk. It's a value-based talk. Thank you so much, sir. Good day.
Thank you. Thanks, sir.
Now, I would request my colleague, Mr. Chetan. You know, Chetan is our design man. You know, he's a man of creativity. He designs everything. He himself is a management graduate.
And he's a very active man in the social media. And he's the pillar when it comes to publicity, you know, the kind of virtual marketing that we do. And I request my friend, Mr. Chetan here, to please introduce our next speaker, Sri Annamalai sir. Thank you. Over to you.
A leader is the one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. Yes, a man who is an ambassador of many youth, Sri Annamalai sir, well known as Singham in the country. Sri Annamalai IPS is basically a mechanical engineer and MBA from IIM Lucknow. He joined civil services in 2011 and served as ASP at Karkala, Udupi, superintendent of police in charge of Udupi district, superintendent of police at Chikmagalur, and DCP Bangalore South. He laid down his office in civil services in 2019 and dedicated himself full time in various passions and pursuits close to his heart. Today, he is known as one of the best motivational speaker in South India and the country in general. He is also an avid reader and a passionate writer. His book, The Agents of Change, How a Life in Khaki Made Me, will release this month. He is the founder and chief servant of the Leaders Foundation, which is very active in Tamil Nadu. He likes to talk to students and empower them in soft skills and life skills. His hobbies include reading Indian and world history, cycling, mountaineering, and farming. We cordially invite you, sir, for today's 12th batch of PGDM inauguration, and welcome you, sir, and over to you. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. Sir, am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Professor Dr. N.R. Shetty, Chairman of Nitte School of Management. Dr. M. Venugopal, Director of Nitte School of Management. Dr. Nagaraj Ram Rao, Chief Guest for the wonderful function that is happening today. Mr. Rohit Punja, Administrator of NET. Dr. H.C. Nagaraj, Principal of NMIT. And all the students who are joining virtually for the virtual inauguration of 12th PGDM batch 2020 to 2022, my respectful greetings to all of you. So this is a very unique inauguration ceremony, very, very unique inauguration ceremony. Many, many batches before you and many, many batches after you will not have a similar kind of inauguration. So one thing I can say for sure, in continuation of what Dr. Nagaraj sir excellently spoke, the next 2 years of your life, the learning that you will take from Nitte School of Management, it will be completely different from the learning that your previous batches have taken, all your seniors have taken, and possibly your juniors would have taken. So maybe we are starting with a very different batch inauguration itself. The world is changing so rapidly and so fast, and things around you is also changing so rapidly, so fast. And whatever we thought impossible, sometime back is being made possible now. Whatever we thought possible sometime back is being made impossible now. This is a kind of flex. The world is going through a major flex now. The last 3-4 months, we are in a major, major flex. This kind of flex happens once in a century. So the years that happens post the flex are the best years for any guy who wants to start new. I would probably rate your batch as the most luckiest batch. You are lucky for two reasons. One, you are entering into a post-graduation when the whole world is in a flux. This is fantastic because when you pass out in 2022, the whole world would be a new world that will be available in front of you. The whole concept of businesses will change. The concept of government is going to change. The concept of leadership is going to change. So it's fantastic. Possibly the next 2 years, you are probably utilizing by doing a post-graduation degree from one of Karnataka's finest, one of India's best college, that is the Nitya School of Management. So I will not talk much. As a guest of honor, today, possibly I will not talk about the motivation and other things. We have some other time in the next 2 years to again talk. But what I'm going to talk now, I will sketch out how the next 2 years is going to be as a management student and what you can possibly do inside your campus to fully utilize your education. Now, how the next 2 years is going to be? If you see now, this year, the GDP, we are estimating it to be contracting by about 3 to 4%. Possibly after many, many years, the GDP is contracting. The industrial output will get contracted and the joblessness might go up. So whatever the government is doing its best, these are things that is unavoidable in a major pandemic year like this. 2020 and 2021 would be a very, very tough year for a lot of people. And this is also a year when you have to redefine a lot of stuff. Till now, if you see an MBA is more like you get into an institute, study for 2 years, you race with every other person to get a placement, and without even knowing what you're going to do, we all get into a company and work for them for the next 30, 40 years. And possibly, many, many MBA students don't have clarity about what they want to do because it's a mad world you are entering in, it's a mad world you are exiting. 2 years, you guys will have a real opportunity to recreate India. So this India has to be recreated. This India cannot be the same old India that was in 2000. Creation has to happen at multiple fronts. It has to. So now the businesses have to become more ethical. The businesses have to become more personal friendly. The businesses have to be more humane in their approach. The businesses have to be more environmentally conscious. That is a new 21st century business, which the world will appreciate. If you see most of the startups, many of my batchmates post my MBA have started a lot of startups. I talk to every single person. They say, we have fired 60% from the company. We have fired 70% from the company. Some companies have fired up to 80%. Now, these are the loyal employees who they have trusted in you. They have put their heart and soul into your company and they have entered into your company. And what happened? One small pandemic have come and very conveniently, we have just fired all of those people because we tell the world this company lives for its profit line, the bottom line, the money that the company makes. That is the sole criteria in which the company is behaving now. So possibly you will be shaping up companies in the future. That company is more humane, the company more people-centered, the company in which profit is important as the people, as important as the planet. All three have to balance each other. Maybe for a change, I am talking to you sitting in my farm. You could see the background trees and whatever cultivation is happening right behind me. Because I have also done an MBA. 2010, I passed out. During my MBA, somehow I was not very clear with respect to the corporate and what I have to do. So at your age, I took a big gamble. So 2009, my first year of MBA, you all have internship. So that is the biggest gamble I took. I said, I'm not sitting for internship. I told people I wanted to see what life is all about. And somehow the civil service and politics, I was very fascinated. So I told my dean, the wonderful dean you have, I told my dean that I want to go and do an internship with the political party. They said, nobody has done an internship with the political party and nobody from an IIM has done it. I said, no, sir, this is what I want to do. Kindly permit me. And I had to move all the way to Mr. Arjun Singh, who was then the union minister for HRD, and go and amend the article of association because political internship was a no-no. I had to move the file. I had to fight it out. Then I had to do an internship with the South Indian political party based out of Tamil Nadu for about 3.5 months. That is how my internship started. And during my MBA, I made it the point to travel a lot. I travel inside UP. I saw what is happening in the society. I saw how people are living their lives. I saw how I can make a difference to their life. Then the civil service examination happened in 2010. So when I took the exam, I joined the Indian Police Service and I continued for about 10 years. If you ask me, what is the trigger point that made all of this happen? Because the MBA made this happen. Because MBA is the only discipline where most of you have chosen consciously. Engineering or arts college just happens because you have passed a 12th standard exam. And it's a natural flow of life. You have gone into a college. But MBA is something which you uniquely choose, which you sit down, you realize what you have to do. I'm sure the inaugural batch, 99% of you would have chosen NITI School of Management very consciously. You would have chosen MBA course very consciously. Many people might not be forced to choose it. So which means you got to make the best use of this MBA. It's not about studying and getting marks. That is all there in good 10 good management books. If you take two Philip Kotler's and 8 other books, from strategy to marketing to finance, you can learn everything from it. But I personally believe an MBA is important because it gives you an opportunity to explore your life. The college library, the faculty members with whom you speak, and the projects you take, you travel across Bangalore or Karnataka. You make it a point to visit all the rural areas. You make it a point to visit all the far-flung areas. You should give equal importance in visiting a swanky campus in Bangalore. The same way you should give an equal importance in visiting a place that is far off. Because you should see humans at their best. You should see humans at their worst. When you do all of this stuff, then fate will touch you. You got to allow fate to touch you. When fate touches you, possibly you choose a career that is closest to you. So my only hope and prayer for all the students who have joined virtually today, that the next 2 years would be the greatest experimental phase of your life. You will experiment so much. You will see people for who they are. And you will not allow the pre-decided mindset to decide how the world should be. For everything you tell me that is true, I can show you 10 things that is false. If you tell me that corporates by their nature should be profit-driven, yes, majorly, I can also show you corporates that are fantastic, that are human-centric, that puts human at the core of what they do. If you tell me that MBA is all about making money, I can show you thousands of people who have done MBAs from some of the finest colleges in India. They have chose to do something in life in which they are fundamentally changing the way human civilization is progressing. If you show me a person who says MBA is more for your personal satisfaction or egocentric, I can show you thousands of people who will tell you MBA is more about opening up who you are. So don't believe possibly what people have done before you. That is all a different part of the world. Now you people have to realize the world is different and you are purely lucky. You are purely lucky because at 2020, at exactly the flux moment, you are getting into an education institution to study. This is the time to study. This is not the time to experiment. This is the time to understand what is right and what is wrong, how the world will shape up. So that is why I said your batch is probably the most luckiest batch in the last 2-3 generations. So fully utilize this MBA. And when you come out, make sure you create something that could be in any field. It could be in the government field. It could be in the business field. It could be in the political field. It could be in the micro sector field. It could be in the agriculture field. But make sure you contribute something back to this nation. In the process, you make money. Nobody is saying that you shouldn't make money and you should only contribute to society. You make money by contributing and live a life that is more purposeful, that is more people-driven. So this is the first, I would not say a message. I think you are also an young person. I am also an young person. But the common connection is we both have done an MBA degree and an MBA changed my life. I'm praying to God that your MBA should also change your life. The second point that I want to convey to you is, now as Nagaraj said before me was hinting, possibly at the same time, your generation is one of the few generations that don't read books, that don't read stuff. For us, reading a WhatsApp message about 8, 9, 9 itself is a big thing daily, and we don't read much. So I would say you have 365 into 2. 730 days to do your MBA. I would request, take it as a challenge and read 100 books. You should read 100 books in 730 days. And keep a diary, keep a pen. And after 2 years, you will tell me the 100 books that you have read have changed your life completely. Because now the only business you have is studying. You don't have any other business. You got to take a book, daily spend about 3 hours, read a stuff. At the same time, go to classroom, listen to your professors and understand where you can be better at and finish your MBA curriculum, whatever course content you have. These 100 books, choose very wisely. These books are the books that is going to make your life. These 100 books are the books that will define who you are. These books can range from a philosophy, it can range from a beautiful literature, it can range from a business book, it can range to a sports book where the leadership is brought out. This can be in politics. The 100 books, you sit down, you choose who you are, what kind of person you are, and what kind of person you want to be. And there is a fair amount of distance you got to travel between who you are and who you want to be. This 100 books should be that gap that bridges both. Because if you don't read that, it will take ages for you to become that person. It will take ages. It might take 10 years. It might take 15 years. You got to go through the experience of life. You have to see the worst and the best of life. You got to see the worst and the best of people. The 15, 20 years of experience might make you the person you want to be. But to short circuit that process, books are a fantastic route. So 100 books, you got to sit down. You got to believe who you are, who you want to be. And the book should act as bridge to bridge that. So 100 books, if you read it, then even after 20 years, you would say the purpose of doing an MBA is worth it. You should not say the purpose of doing an MBA is to increase your salary package. No, that is not the concept. Salary package can be increased by doing n number of things. The purpose of doing an MBA is to chisel out a better human being, who you are now and who you want to be. The 730 days, you have to sit down and chisel it daily, day by day. From morning till night, you got to chisel it. You don't have any other business except to do that now, because you possibly, all of you are at the age of 20, 21 and 22. Use this age purposefully, because you will not get this again. And at 25, 27, you will be in the life's process. You will be going through the motions of life. You'll be married with children, and you'll be having n number of problems outside, EMIs and all those stuff. You might not have the 2 years again, the beautiful years again in your life to sit down and study what you want to be. So please utilize that. The third message, or maybe the conversation I want to tell all of you, is be very ethical leaders. The society needs leaders who are very ethical. The society doesn't need us who can speak good English, who can say, I can do this, I can do that, who can command. No, that is the World War II centric leadership. After World War II, when most of the business schools went for a very different concept, Harvard Business School is as old as 150, 160 years, when all the schools revised their curriculum majorly to keep them in tune with the assembly line manufacturing world, post the World War II, then MBA has taken a turn for worse. MBA hasn't taken a turn for the best. It has taken a turn for the worse because the concept of authority came in, the concept of manufacturing and concept of measuring human being came in, the concept of money came in, the concept of time and money-centric came in. All those came in after the World War II. Now, 2020 post-corona, this world is going to need leaders who are fantastic, who are ethical, and who have a lot of moral values. Who will do right? They don't care what others speak about them. They don't care how the world looks at them. They don't care what people will write about them. They will only do what is right. What is right for them, what is right for the people whom they lead, and what is right for the organization which has placed their trust on this human being. So I'm sure most of the MBA curriculum, what I've read at least in 2008 and 2010, this emphasis is not there. This emphasis on moral values, emphasis on leadership, emphasis on trust is not there. I hope and pray the 2020 MBA from now on would make you fantastic leaders who are so ethical. Because this country is so short of ethical leaders. We are so short of ethical leaders. And I would say very poor. Because you see, the biggest bank in India, private sector bank, the chairman goes to jail for doing a fraud. You ask why? Because the chairman has done an MBA like you. He has done a double MBA. He has gone to a school in US. He has done a second MBA as well. And they go to fraud because one fine day they have decided that I'm going to cheat people. They keep cheating for about a year and a half, and finally the law catches with them. They go to jail. Now, is there a problem with the education? Because they've gone to some of the finest schools in the world. Is there a problem with who they are? I might not say so. I would say there is a problem with the way they've consumed education. There is a problem with the way they've seen the world. There's a problem with the way they've seen authority. There's a problem with the way they've used their authority. Now, biggest airline companies in India, some of the finest people from the world, some of the best business guys are there. But end of the day, one fine day, the whole airline collapses because the fraud after fraud happens for a long time and they all go to jail. Again, why? The problem, we have leaders, but the problem is we don't have ethical leaders. Because the current model of MBA, it pushes you to be more competitive. It pushes you to be ultra competitive. There's a chapter in my book as well. It pushes you to be ultra competitive. And you all fight for placements. Take it from me, in the next 1 year after that, you all fight for placements. Probably I know many of you might not even talk to your roommate. Many of you might not even talk to that guy, because if you believe both of you are fighting for the same job, all this nonsense I believe has to end. Because MBA is not a place where they make you to run running races to see who comes first. No. MBA is a place which will help you to realize who you are. So if you apply this MBA learning to most of the businesses that have failed in India, which have intentionally failed, which have done fraud to their customers and all those people, the simple fact we can say, the leaders weren't ethical. The leaders were self-centric. The leaders were only working for their pay package. Now the next generation of leaders who have to lead our country have to be absolutely ethical, have to be absolutely clear in leading people, because the political field also needs leaders like you. 10 years from now, 12 years from now, one fine day you will decide that you'll get into politics. You will try to change the system from within. People need you. And the businesses need leaders like you. Some of the finest businesses in India are waiting for leaders like you to lead people. So I would say the third and the most important part, use this MBA to be more ethical. Use this MBA to be moral driven. Because if you see, there is a beautiful book written called What Money Can't Buy. It is written by a professor called Dr. Michael Sandel. Dr. Michael Sandel is a professor in the United States of America, and he teaches management. And I would request one of the first book you all should read is What Money Can't Buy. And Michael Sandel has also written a beautiful book on justice. And his course in where he teaches, it has got millions of viewers. It's an open course he conducts. So two books I think is a must read for you before you start your MBA classes. Before the real classes starts in the next 3-4 months, once the corona subsides, you should read What Money Can't Buy, Hana Yeno, Namakku Kodalik Agala, and Justice. Because it will be a good grounding for you before you enter into an MBA, and then you will start utilizing the next 730 days of your life to become a better person. So I will not talk much, because whatever 3 points I've spoken, it's all slightly heavy points. It fundamentally might make you to rethink who you are. And last but not the least, Harsha Bogle, the famous cricket commentator, he said, somebody asked him, what IIMs did not teach you? He studied his MBA from IIM Ahmedabad. So somebody asked Harsha Bogle, what IIMs did not teach you? He said, IIMs did not teach me to relax. And this is also one big problem with Indian management institutes, where we believe more time you keep running around, the more you can accomplish. I would say, use this time also to explore your inner side, explore your spiritual side, to explore who you are by digging deep into your human mind, human psyche. So use this time also to relax, to write a book if you want, if you're having that, to do yoga. At the same time, you are caught up in a very tough curriculum. MBA is tough by its very nature, the way it is designed. Use that also. Use the time to read book. A busy man will always find time. A busy man will always find time to do yoga. A busy man will always find time to play. A busy man will always find time to read. So you should be busy, busy bees, and you should find all the time in the world to do all the stuff you want. May God be with you. I'm seeing about 76, 80 people in this Google Meet. I'm not sure what is the batch strength of the 12th batch. I hope and pray all the 80 of you are the batch strength, whatever the number is. The God will be kind to you. You will have a fantastic time at Nitte School of Management. All of you would be very healthy. That is my prayer. You all would pass out as a group, healthy. And you all would pass out as wealthy in terms of mind, in terms of what you have read, with a lot of jnana. And you all would pass out into a country that will be waiting to welcome you in 2022. That country is desperately short of moral leaders, ethical leaders, short of leaders who know who they are, so that they can lead people to where they want to go. So I thank Professor Karunakar Roy and the other professors of the Nitte School of Management who gave me an opportunity to talk to you today. It's a privilege to talk to the inaugural batch. The only problem is we are doing it virtually. I would like to sit with you in the campus, talk to you, understand who you are, and then share my experience as well. So right now, post my policing stint, I've taken a shift into politics now. I've taken a shift into a foundation, so we all do. We have a lot of volunteers. We do a lot of grassroots work in Tamil Nadu. So you're most welcome to visit us as part of your curriculum, part of your school visit, college visit. So you can come and see the work that our boys do. back in Tamil Nadu, in terms of skilling of youth or in terms of organizing farmers for creating a farmers produce organization to lead India into a better time. If you ask me, where did I get all that moral courage? Because I've done something, quit something, doing something now. I would say it's all the MBA that came. The MBA gave me that platform. It gave me that courage. It gave me that vision. It told me I can't fail. I can't fail. Provided I put my heart and soul into what I'm doing, I can't fail. So that is what I'm doing now, with all the best wishes to all the people here and to my co-speaker, Dr. Nagaraj sir, who gave an excellent chief guest address, and to the chairman, Dr. N.R. Shetty, a person whom I deeply respect and admire for the way NITE has stood. I started my career as an ASP in NITE. NITE has come from a small village called NITE near Karkala. So I've visited their engineering college. I've spoken to a lot of top people there. It's such a great college, such a great human beings they are. They keep asking, what can I give it back to society? Am I giving enough? Can I give more? That is what I call NITE metal. The top leadership of NITE is made up of that kind of a moral fiber. So it's a real privilege to talk before Dr. N.R. Shetty, sir, as well. Dr. M. Venugopal, who is the able director for the School of Management, and for all the people here, let God be with you. Let it be a fantastic 2 years of your life. Don't even waste even a single 7:30 day. Please make sure you read 100 books. Make sure you do a lot of relaxation. Make sure you find your life's purpose. So thank you so much for the opportunity. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Annamalai sir. It was, in fact, listening to your speech is like merging and melting. You know, the message, every word can be written down. The message of 100 books in 730 days probably will go down for all time.
In fact, we will invite you sooner than later, to ensure that they have taken the first book. And we will ensure that they make a book talk in your presence, sir. Really, I promise. And
thank you, sir.
I am going to start another 100 books right from today, because I just love books, and I love the people who talk about books. What a great message you gave at this juncture, because you rightly said your job is to study, and don't get into anything else. This is the message that every motivation speaker like you, of course, they should follow, you should do that. I'm sure we are really blessed to have you amidst us for the kind of talk you do, because you are the person who always walks the talk. I have seen, being a part of Udupi, I have seen the way you functioned there. I was one of the deepest admirers, and I met you, and you came to our campus also. You came to Engineering College also. Sir, please make it a point to come again and as often as possible. And these 100 books assignment, we will not forget, sir. And on the day the students complete 100 books, we'll come and report to you. Thank you so much. And you really made that day. You are really fantastic, sir. Great. God bless. Now, friends, quickly, because I'll just take you through a small PPT which covers about our organization, our institute, and I won't take more than 20 minutes, because especially the students, because we gave promises to students, and on the back of those promises, they have come here, and they should know, they have right to know as an evidence, what kind of evidence is available. And I'm going to take you quickly to the people, only 20 minutes. Kindly go through this, just listen to me as you see the PPT also. Please pin your screen. I'll not take much of a time. I'll just see as Dr. Nagaraj sir rightly said here, today the entire conglomerate of NITE is NITE, as sir rightly said, many people take it as NITI, N-I-T-T-I, it's not that. NITE is a village. And in fact, what started in 1917 as one high school today is a conglomerate of more than 36 significant institutions in different disciplines. And most of these institutes are highly rated by the rating bodies here. And what today we are having 36 institutions. Look at the journey of ours. It is, you know, the 36 institutions. If you look at the Nitte University, Nitte University is a part of Nitte Trust. Nitte University is one of the youngest universities, ranked 70th by NIRF, that is institutional, the rating framework body, 70th youngest university of the country. And several Nitte School of Management, which is a constituent, we are rated as 7th in Bangalore City by you know, the careers 360. And our prestigious engineer college, that's NMIT, Nitte Meenakshi Institute of Technologies, ranked at 128th. And the campus of this NMIT is rated as the greenest campus of the country by AACTE. And with a background of 4,500 faculty, 20,000 students, 130 courses, and yes. And so today we are running a whole lot of medical, dentistry, management courses with three campuses. And our founder, we should be both to our founder, Justice K. Sadanand Hegde, was the Speaker of Lok Sabha. He was the judge of Supreme Court of India, and it was his vision in 1979, and he, under his vision leadership, today we have got a big edifice of Nitte Group. Sri Vinay Hegde is our Chancellor of Nitte University, and he is the President of Nitte Education Trust. You know, his very name spells lot of enthusiasm. He is our patron, and he is the one, a great inspirer. And in Bangalore campus, we have Professor Dr. N.R. Shetty, the doyen of higher education in India and abroad. If you look at any of the leading commissions or the committees appointed by Government of India in the last few decades, and invariably Dr. N.R. Shetty, he is the advisor or a part of that. And today, luckily for us, he is our mentor too for Nitte School of Management. Yes. Mr. Rohit Punja is the administrator with a lot of corporate background. He's at an entire Nitte Education Trust, and he is going to deliver a talk at the later part of this day. Dr. M. Venugopal, he is the dynamic leader of our institute, Nitte School of Management here. In the last 1.5 years, he has brought sheet anchor. He played a sheet anchor role. You know, in the ship, there is always sheet anchor. He protects. He acted like a sheet anchor. You know, he brought this Nitte School of Management with the present branding to the outside world in all parameters today. Now, yes. If you look at the placement, today the Nitte School of Management is placed 7th in Bangalore and 28th in India. And today we are having the maximum presence students from northern states, as many as 15 to 16 states students from. Therefore, it's a pan-India presence in Nitte Group. Yes, as you would have seen for yourself, friends, we are insightful, we are practical, and we are employable. That's what our mission statement is all about. Look at today, we have, you know, the market management market knows us. We are the first institute in the country to introduce very unique 5 specializations. One is, of course, age old, you know, which is equally important, general management, doctoral finance. I am a banker myself. I didn't introduce myself. I am Dr. Jairam Shetty. I'm a professor in the banking studies and entrepreneurship general management here. I worked for a bank. And coming back, yes, in marketing, HR, operations, and this is the general management. Then we have introduced another unique course on business analytics, because this is one course which rules the roost of this whole economy today. Then
agri business management is another important course. We are very close to the agricultural university in Bangalore here, and this course I'm sure is going to change the destiny, the kind of career you are going to have in agribusiness management are really exciting and numerous. Then we have got healthcare management, a new specialization about which we have brought out a booklet, will release to you soon. Then the management consulting is the most sought after today. If you look at friends, everything is one of consulting. Every managerial decision is based on consulting, and we are, and the students who take this specialization, they are going to emerge either as employees or as consultants. So these are the job opportunities under business analytics. In general management, we have people can be placed here. We have got a good rapport with these companies. Only a few are mentioned here. There are many more to come. Yes, next. In business analytics, these are the leading companies with whom you have got the contact. We can help you get a place there. And therefore, this is what you can look for. Of course, this specialization comes in the second semester. You know, as you know, it's a 4 semesters, first semester, general semesters. And by the end of 6 months later, of course, we the teachers are going to help you to choose which is best for you, looking at your aptitudes, attitudes, and pursuits. Next, in agribusiness management, this upcoming one area, because India is essential in agrarian economy, 70% of people here. It's about the, you know, high ends of jobs that are available, you know, in every area, as Dr. Nagraj Ramrao said, you know, to the present education, new education policy breaks all barriers. It is, everything is non-linear. Any student can choose a basket of subjects. An engineer student can talk, he can study about constitution. Therefore, in the liberalized education policy, all doors are open for you. Only thing is you have to enter. So that in that year, then healthcare management for a country like India, you know, therefore we need very badly, lot many opportunities available. Just, you know, it's an opportunity, a new door for new jobs and great jobs. Then comes about consulting. These are the companies where only few examples are given here, and many more opportunities. You can work as a consultant, as a change agent. And of late, in addition to these things, please note, it's very important, in addition to PGDM course, which for 2 years, we have introduced already 35 professional certification courses, short-term, highly job-intensive, very relevant to the market, just a bang on. Just these certification courses for a period from 1 to 2 months can help you, and we are, can help you get a better placement in addition to, therefore, it is like a bonus. These 35 degree sources will be certified by your university, Nitya University. And in addition, we have got a partnership. We have partnered with one of the prestigious global workforce, this management organization, which has got a universal presence here in various areas. We are going to offer 6 certificates under the aegis of this global workforce, which is a universal body. In all continents, they are there. And look at your friends. One is global, one the workforce management and analytics, people analytics, industry relations, and of course, POSS, prevention of sexual harassment. That's all an important area for all managers to know about. You know, then you got business continuity planning, the certification courses, and the design thinking. There's a very, we have got all in labs actually. In fact, I'm very happy to tell that. Just as we have got 5 courses, we are going to have 5 dedicated, powerful labs also. Therefore, you are not just in a classroom here. After classrooms, you are in the labs. If not in the labs, you are with the experts of the visiting faculty. 50% of the visit faculties, they are already the corporate bosses themselves or the consultants. And therefore, they are going to handhold you and help you. So it's a multi-pronged approach, friends, my dear friends. And our highlights quickly, specializations, then there will be every student will be handled by two mentors, one from the institute and the other from the corporate.
on any given day you have got, and don't think these mentors will bug you or bother you. They are only helping you. Therefore, and that kind of mentoring will take place round the clock. And we have got a, you know, strong industry connect. Bangalore is a very important, as you know, friends, is a happening place. The Peenya Industrial Estate, which is very close to Bangalore, is the largest industrial estate in Asia. There are more than 8,000 organization MSMEs are there. And we have got the connect with umpteen opportunity visits, tours, and by 4 semesters, your placement is guaranteed. You can take it for granted, but of course, you'll be with us. You know, you can't run away, and we'll place you well. Your placement is guaranteed. And yeah, specialization led by domain experts, and all these 4 specialized 5 specialized will be led by, like I mentioned about Professor Ranganath Iyengar, Professor Anala Padmanabh, Professor Gilabal. So they are the kind of people who are going to lead these courses in addition to the internal faculty. So therefore, this goes therefore the classroom exposure, the lab exposure, and the internship, and then placement. All these 4 will take place, you know, incrementally in a non-linear way. And then, of course, I need not tell you, friends, and placement. Just to see, just let you know the next, please. The teaching look at here is basically, it's an experiential teach. As you know, management, as Annamalai sir said also, it is not just, read in the books here. The kind of teaching will be based on cases, based on interactive sessions, based on at least 1 day in a week, probably. Yes, surely, why probably? 1 day in a week. In the second semester, you are going to spend in the corporate office. You are going to sit in a boardroom. You will see how the boardroom works there. Therefore, and analysis, a lot of contemporary art analysis here, and on an analytical mode here, case studies, field projects, and the, of course, expert guest speakers. Therefore, and presentations, of course, you know, as I said, you know, the 100 book also, this could be one of the assignments here. In other words, the entire PGM course is based on dialogues. It's not a monologue. It's not just the teacher part, maybe just 30%, 70%, you know, you are going to find a groove for yourself, you know. You are going to, like a tree, you have to branch out. Like a tree, you have to create new leaves every day. This is a message for your friends. You are like a tree, branch out, uninterrupted, and create new leaves. And therefore, we have got excellent facilities, the classrooms. You have seen yourself soon, of course, within a matter of 1 month, probably, God willing. You know, of course, I shouldn't say that. You know, from tomorrow also, the orientation starts here. And when you see for yourself, you will really believe more than ever you did. Well, equipped computing, internet, seminar hall. This is a hall where you are here, one of the halls, hospital facilities, transport, gym, sports, canteen, ATM. There are 2 bank branches here, you know. So therefore, I'm also a banker here. For any banking support, you can always be here. And in addition to that, we have introduced what is known as student to empower. Therefore, this kind of mentoring takes place on a continuous basis here. E-mentoring. Even, see, it is not just a COVID kind of atmosphere. Even the situation will ease soon. Problems are not forever. And this will take place parallelly. Along with the classes, along with the labs, you will also have a kind of additional, you know, this kind of e-mentoring will take place. See, during the COVID period, you know, our students did not, among yourself, I'm very happy to tell that, so we 376 certification courses were offered during the last lockdown period. I tell you, friend, there was, see, lockdown world outside, but there was no breakdown. There was no breakdown. And I can tell you, friend, there's actually breakthrough. 362 certificates are actually completed by students. And if you look at in the new batch, see, first year students, 228 new batch, 134 students completed this before entering the class year. You see, this is very important. Before before seeing the world go, before even seeing Bangalore, they are already richer with the 134 which are highly job relevant programs. Friends, what more you need that? You know, it is just happening. You can't stop yourself. You know, I believe in that. You know, really, it's actually, I'm seeing the thing. I've been here as a professor for the last 15 years, 30 years as a banker, as a bank trainer. I've seen the things happening. You know, you will see at least 10 times more than you heard me. Yes. So we have got a collaboration with NDSU, North Dakota State University. Therefore, that we'll discuss later because there's a partner. After 1 year, some students probably could go to US also, get the certification, and a lot of jobs in World Bank, you know, AD. Now, is a faculty, just 1 second, sir. Yeah. This is the head of department, Dr. Siddharth Panda. That is no other than me, Jairam Shetty. So, you know, we are here at your disposal. Our job is to serve you, and we'll do that. Then we have Kokesha Rao. He's a controller. He's an MBA BTech. Then Richaji, who just introduced on the guest here. She is the brightest professors of all of us here. Then we have Dr. Kishore, an expert in management. Then we have Prasad Roop. Then he's an MTech. He's an IIT person, soft skill trainer. And all these things are working for your benefit. Yes. Then we have Ranganath Iyengar, who is going to lead several sessions on management consulting, international IBM, and other areas here. He himself is was a country head and presently is the most sought after management consultant. He's a teacher, a very passionate teacher, mentor. And then we have Prof. Atul Sharma, who's a senior, was holding senior HR positions in Bosch Group, Cummins Group, and DCM. And he's teaching a couple of subjects in institute regularly the last 2 years of teaching. Then we have got Professor Anila Padmanabhash, you know. She holds CA from India and CFM abroad from CIMA, MBA from Stanford University, and she's a senior consultant. And she is still, you know, it's a regular consultant, the World Bank, McKinsey & Co. and EY. And Professor Anila Padmanabh is the most sought after, most looked after professor in the campus. And she's very energized, excited. She's asking me, Jairam Shetty, when the session should start. That's it. Then we have got an HR expert in Bangalore and the whole country, Greenland. He was senior positions in Bosch, Siemens, Mercedes, Benz, Startup Group. And he was the chairman of NIPM, National Institute of Personnel Management. And the only four, and there are many more are there, about whom you will choose later. Then we have got a board of studies. So this is the unique part of that. We have roped in. That's not correct, actually. We have invited. I should not say roped in. We have invited, and they're very kind to us, assent to that. These are the people, you know, they're a part of this board of studies here. Augustus Azaria, Harish Baba, our own HOD of MBA department, Dr. S. Nagar, the principal, Anand Padmanabh, Acharya Lu, Professor Dinesh, Dr. Sarika, Professor Greenaran, Atul Sharma, and Dr. Vinod Kumar. He is an IT expert in the field of consulting. He is a country head. Yes. Then we have Board of Studies. Then we got the Advisory Council. Look at the kind of profile. In fact, I must tell you, friends, who is who of Bengaluru are here? Yes. Jayesh Chandi is the, you know, CHRO of the Connect Business Solutions. We have got Satyashesha Sai, Director Xerox, Jeet, Dr. B. Patwari, Managing Director Pinnacle Consultants, Professor Alex Matthews, look at the Landmark Group, is one of the very prestigious organizations, Srikant, General Manager, HR Siemens Technology, Randit TP, Director Equipment, ESF Pacific, and Volvo, Manoj Kumar, Chief Executive Officer of Pinnacle. Then Mr. Srinivas, MD, Amaze Career, they're all very important organizations in Bangalore. They are the landmarks, actually. Then we have Srinivas, MD, Amaze Career Guidance, C.A. Rajesh, is that accountant, Pandari Sothex, Sai Krishna Mohan, you remember, Director, Data Management, Honeywell. Recently, he held a seminar also.
many other esteemed chief ethics, compliance and privacy officer UNICEF, Suraj Chetty, director HR Airbus, Ashok Kamaya, director HR, and all the very important Schneider Electric, Amish Sharma, vice president, Volvo Group, Partha, Prajeev Ganguly, co-founder, Global Workforce Management Forum, then Dr. Shukumar, he's the founder of this Global Workforce Management, with whom we already got a partnership, you know, kind of partner, we have done that. Then Mr. Rathod, consultant in retail management, Mr. Vishwanath, Tokonda, entrepreneur, author and award-winning international coach,
London,
based in London. Recently, he also delivered a webinar talk, Rajarajan Satyamurthy, Senior Vice President, Quell Health India, then Sunila SM, Associate Director of Finance, Accenture, Mano Singh, founder, these are tomorrow. So friends, please note that that's the kind of partnership we have there. These people are going to help you. Ultimately, see, when we have got these people here, the final benefits will flow to you. You are the ultimate beneficiary of this. Thank you.
Placement.
We have placed possibly everyone in the last 9 years, and in the last 1 year, a placement has been rigorous pursuit. 97% to 98% have been placed here. And we have introduced a system called Gold Card. What it means is, from the day you are placed, for next 5 years, the Tay School of Management people will be around you. Suppose 1 year later, you find the placement is not good enough for you, and we are there to for higher positions. So we'll be completely monitoring and helping you. Should you need to change a job also, you don't have to break your head yourself. Keep the head for some other purposes, you know. We are there as your guide, philosopher for the next 5 years. Then look at recently, only this news came on yesterday, I tell you friends, from the senior batch, pastoral batch, you know, these two students, they're already placed. See, this is girl, Juhi Nivedita. She got placed in Baiju with a 10 lakh, note it, 10 lakh during COVID time. It is no easy, please note that. She got, and therefore, now she is not smiling in a photo, and she will smile and talk later here. Juhi, one of the brightest students of college, you know, she got the biggest package. Then again, Purushottam Reddy, he is a 2020 passed out. He got a 10 lakh package from Baiju. Then another student, Raghavendra, got placed in phone pay for 6 lakh package here. And all other students, Joyce named 8 lakh. And all other students are in different stages of placement. And soon, sooner than later, they will be placed here. Probably by the time you come here, they will come and shake their hand, you know, they will touch your hands. There's no problem by that time, you know, not a virtual yes handshake. These guys are going to dance with you out of happiness and ecstasy. Congratulations, students. Our linkage, ASSOCHAM is a very prestigious organization. Then CII, IFCCI, MSME. MSME is a very important area in Bangalore. You know, in fact, I must tell you that My PhD is in MSME. My heart is there. Small micro enterprises. Then Indo-Italian Chamber, ISCC, Indo-American. Then Federation of FKCC, one of the more than 100 years old organization. And these are the organizations with whom we are going to have that. And I tell you, friends, whenever these organ hold the national seminars, you will be participating. You must know this at the country level. So therefore, this is the kind. Then our recruiters, you can just see for your. When you see a color, they said you remember us, and you are seeing a color of your life yourself. You know the UB Group, Bata, ITC, Baiju, already recruited two students from group here, and Biocon, of course, very prestigious. EY, Excite, Thomson, ICSS, Smith, FedEx, KPMG. For accounting students, is the dream company to go to or go with, and you know. HDFC Bank, then Chanik, L&T, Archer, yes, Axis Bank, Oracle, and you have got a lot of opportunity banks also. Next. And of course, you know,
jack of all trades. Our students cannot just sit here. They will gel, they will mix, they will dance, and they will rock. I'm sure sitting where you are also rocking now. And sooner or later, we have got a cricket. Mr. Chetan himself is a great cricketer himself. He's a very avid sportsman. You know, he's a bodybuilder himself. Chetan, the smartest guy on the campus here. And we are there with you for all this program. And come on, guys, we'll dance. We'll rejoice and dance. Dance with success. Please note that. Ask Anamala says that don't relax. Don't relax. See the dream. See the dream sitting only, sitting awake. That's what the president says. These are the facilities you can see for yourself. Soon you can order for the one. The moment you come here, gym, all these places, you'll rock here. 5,000 students like you. Young students who you can be comfortable with, who you can be friendly with, and who you can love also as human beings. Yes, why not? Yes, these are the various important functions we have had. This is actually Sir Vinay Hegde, our Chancellor. Sir, yes.
Yeah. Book release is financial.
Yes.
Board of Studies meeting.
Board of Studies meetings there, yes. You can see the, this is, yeah. Various meetings, this is last time Professor Annamalai came here to speak. You can see that.
One of the students getting the prize.
The students getting prize there. That is the meeting in progress. That's the BOS meeting. Then the Yes. So these are the various meets here. You can see for yourself.
The musical event.
So Chetan is reminding, he loves music, you know, it's a musical event. We have got 3 days called Anadyanta. Anadyanta of NMIT is the most showcased event of the country.
Arman Malik has come.
Arman Malik. His son. He had come this year, and every year. Neha Kakkar had come. And every year we have got one cine celebrity. Just in tune with your youngsters requirements here, and 3 days a very important program, and we are also participating in that, you know. And his program, Professor Panda, one of our professors, he's a Chodi, he held it, you know, the kind of programs he did that. Our teachers are very busy, you know, including myself, if you permit me. We are not lazy people, we are very busy people, you know, we are on the feet. Yes, thank you. So thank you so much, friends. So thank you for listening to this talk here. Now, I'm sorry if I have taken a little longer time. Now, we are coming to almost the end of this year. I will request a few students when someone comes and says himself, seeing is believing, you know. So I would request a few students to start with, you know, last time we had two of the group captains as students here. Please note that. Two group captains. Previous to that, one colonel came and did his PGDM. And one of such group captains, I would request Ms. Vishwanath Shanai. He has just completed PGDM with a flying colors. He is a topper actually. And Ms. Vinay Shanai is going to join his services soon. And in the meanwhile, he has got his PGDM. Yeah. May I request Captain Vishwanath Shanai to come line and take 2-3 minutes?
Yes, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you're audible.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving me this opportunity to speak to the new students. My target audience for today is generally focused towards the new students who are going to join. I want to share my experience in this college. We have a fine set of professors. They have been already introduced. Girinarayan sir, Ranganath Iyengar, Anila Padmanabhan ma'am, Atul Sharma sir, Dr. Venugopal, and to top it all, our own Jairam Shetty, who is the at the age of more than 60, he is the one of the most dynamic professors in the college. These professors are having wide variety of experience in various fields, and their plethora of knowledge, they can impart training and knowledge on any field, any in their field of exposure. But what's very important for the students is, you know, they say you can take the horse to the water, not make it drink. The drinking has to be done by the horse himself. Hence, these professors who are there, so much experience, you have to go to them to seek knowledge. Once you approach them on any doubts or any issue, you come to know a lot of things which cannot be explained as part of a, you know, standard curriculum. You come to know a lot of things through that, through their interactions with them. And when they are teaching you, like when Professor Ranganath Iyengar teaches international business management, or Girinarayan sir talks about HR, when Anila Padmanabhan ma'am speaks about finance, accounting, CA and whatnot, you know, you must relate it to the current affairs. Like in economics or international business management, when we talk about trade wars between the various countries, like US and China, when these professors give you insight into, you know, how these whole world economy takes shape, how it has happened around 200 years back, and how the international HR takes place, on what basis, what are the, you know, cultural aspects we have to look into. You know, it don't look at this as just another, you know, theoretical lecture. You must feel that, you know, you are getting a big exposure and experience that lecture given by the people, by reading the newspapers, by correlating what is happening with the current affairs. Why I'm telling this is because this is not a regular course, as various speakers previously brought out. It is a heterogeneous mix of various people, of students of various background. I believe you have two officers, very senior officers from the defense services, some students from the IT industry with 5 years experience, 2 years experience. Nearly 50% of the students have just completed their degree and joining the course this year. And all of you, see, hence, and they are from arts, commerce, engineer, somebody is BBM, somebody is an engineer, you know, various background. Interact with the students as well as a professor to gain the experience. Don't look at this, look at this PGDM, okay, I have got another degree, one more degree in my crown. I got BA, BSc, BCom degree, and PGDM is another degree in my crown. Don't look at this as just another degree. Just look at what you are learning. What are the key takeaways from this degree? What you experience? I think 50% of the students are, you know, just, and I believe they have not even finished their degree. They are going to give final exam somewhere in September, October, and they are going to join. For them, it will be a great experience to interact with the people out of their, you know, area of domain of understanding. This is a very good opportunity for all of you to get a great experience of life. It is an experience of lifetime. And as far as coming to the college campus is concerned, now this is COVID times. We are having a virtual inauguration. But when you come to the college campus, hopefully vaccine will come through and these times will we'll get over soon, and we will interact physically with one another. The college campus is very vibrant and dynamic. Most of you must have visited. You get positive vibes when you enter the, you know, college campus. When you move around, that positive vibes is very important. When you see the students and other students and all, there is an, you know, studious atmosphere is there. You enjoy your life, but at the same time, utilize this, you know, well-stocked library, and interact with the staff very, you know, courteously, and you will have a great experience. Next 2 years are very important for future you know endeavors of yours, and what Mr. Annamalai is a former IPS officer brought out was very you know significant. You know, that ethical leadership, what is lacking in this country, you people must provide ethical leadership in future wherever you go there. And there are a lot of business ethics also will be taught to you. See, classroom teaching, you know, doesn't make you ethical leader. What you imbibe, your principles, values, your attitude towards life and your attitude towards other make you an ethical leader. Learn those, you know, aspects and be a good citizen of this country. And thank you very much, sir, for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, Group Captain Vishwanath Shanaji. In fact, so nice of you. Now, another five students, I would request each one to take just 2 minutes, please, in the interest of time also. Rest we'll see when you come back here. Okay, may I request Raghavendra, please take 2 minutes and quickly bang on his tell. Raghavendra. Are you there, Raghavendra? Then Dr. Swati, can you come online? Dr. Swati, our student.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon. Yeah. Good afternoon, all the esteemed guests, my professors, and my colleagues. First of all, I, Dr. Swati Mishra, student of second year, welcome you all to Nitti School of Management. This day is about the newcomers, the new students. We all know that a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step, and we all will be the future leaders. I believe happiness is a journey and not a destination. So it gives me an immense pleasure in sharing my next 1 year with all by building a great relationship and sharing knowledge together. There are few days in human life when one is truly elated. The first day in college is one of them. There are so much to be curious about. I call this excitement the spark within you that makes you feel truly alive today. Today I'm going to talk about like my journey in NSOM. It is getting better every day, I can say. I, being a doctor, a postgraduate in psychology and emergency medical services, it has been a tremendous transformation for me, like from medical to management. Management study not only provided me a wealth of knowledge and experience, but I started to unleash the cocktail of finance, marketing, human resource after joining this institution. I personally have realized MBA is all about skill, knowledge, attitude, relationship, networking, and not only about the assignments which we generally talk about. It has been a great experience for me to learn from the wisdom of great industrial experts and our own professors like Jairam Shetty sir, Satya Siddharth Panda sir, Richa ma'am, Anila ma'am, Ranganath sir, Giri Narayan sir, Atul Sharma sir, and so on and so forth. List is very long, so I will just cut it short. Then learning is a lifelong journey, and initial 6 months of journey is very crucial for transformation, as you would be ended up enlightened with lots of thoughts, learning, experiences from professors, esteemed industrial experts, friends. Then we have life projects, industrial visits, different competitions, and many extracurricular activities. What makes me more confident about a bright future is the individual mentoring classes, which is given by none other than our own professors. It gives us a great opportunity to actually work on our strengths and enhance our skills. We have many clubs also, like which are headed by my own colleagues. Like we have HR club, which is headed by Ms. Sujo George, marketing club by Mr. Sai Venkatesh, financial club by Mr. Anil, sports club by Mr. Sai Ishwar, cultural club is by Ms. Harshita P. Rao, and public speaking club by Ms. Sanjana Kundar. It helps in upskilling ourselves and we stay more informed about all the spheres of life. During COVID-19, things are a little different, but with a well-planned, digitally transformed cloud platform, NSOM has made it possible to have a continuum in learning. We had no breaks. And you can embark your knowledge by e-learning specialized module-based certification that NSOM is going to provide. We have a very good supportive teaching and non-teaching staff, a well-organized transportation facilities, digitally transformed online classes, e-library facilities that will be privileged. Books, magazines, journals, Emerald membership, individual study spaces will become your wayfinder for better knowledge. I have few key takeaways. First is decide what is important and choose your specialization carefully. Set aside quality time, maybe an hour every weekend, to reflect on what you have studied, and so that you can emphasize on your journey better. And the experience is entirely what you make out of it. Every step you take makes a mark for those that are yet to follow. You may explore and develop it in the way you believe it is best, because your footstep is unique. Inspire and be inspired. Welcome all to NSOM. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Swatis. I recognize the presence of our honorable guest faculty, Professor Manuman Reddy. Thank you, sir, for being there. Hello, Reddy, sir. Thank you for being there. Now, another four, quickly, only 2 minutes and not even a second more, because we have to close the program, you know. May I request Meenakshi to come online, 2 minutes only. It's a kind of challenge for you from the teachers.
Good afternoon, everyone. Yes, I am online. So I'm Meenakshi, and life at NSOM is like, it'll be like, even the staff will be very friendly with the students. They take care of each and every aspect of the journey very carefully, and they see that we enlist ourselves with each and every knowledge, and they give us access, how to access the knowledge from each and every point of our life. And yes, as Mr. Annamalai sir said, MBA is doing to know, explore ourselves and knowing what we are. And in NSOM, I can be sure that they make us know what we are. They enrich us, they improve us, and they maintain us very well. They give continuous mentorships, and even the staffs are really good. So life is very good in NSOM. We have a lot of cultural activities, we have a lot of technical activities, management fest, and they even help us, mentor us when we go to other colleges for fest, how to apply over there, how to do it over there. Mentoring is really good. So I would like to say that finally, the cultural activities, what we have done, the management fest and all, we enjoy them a lot. And even Anandantya, the cultural fest, which we had it for 3 days, is really the last thing. The main thing I miss during the COVID is the life at NSOM. Even though we are being in contact with virtually, it's really hard that we miss it physically. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, Meenakshi. So nice. May I request finally Juhi to come? Juhi, 2 minutes.
Yes, sir. First of all, good afternoon, everyone. So rather than being so professional, I would like to come to our level, a student level, and speak. So as Mr. Shetty sir mentioned that I got placed, I'm really happy for that. That is all because of NSOM. They've given me a really good training. Actually, the training for the placements, everything was how to groom yourself, how to dress yourself, how to walk in an interview, how to sit in an interview. From the very little, a very minute point, they have mentioned me how I should present myself. I had a good communication, so they have mentored me of how to use that communication in my real-time phase. So what I would like to tell is, this is a really great experience you'll have in NSOM. You're going to be getting a really good benefit from NSOM. So all the best for everyone. And finally, I welcome each and everyone to the family of NSOM. Thank you.
Yeah, that's just so nice. Congrats, Juhi. You really made it. We are very proud of you. And thank finally, you, may I request Group Captain Srikant, just 2 minutes, Professor, please come online and finish. Group Captain Srikant ji.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah, good afternoon, to all the faculty and to all the students. I won't give you a very long lecture. I'll simply stick to one particular point. Identify for yourself what is the purpose for which you are joining this institution. If your purpose is identified, rest of the job is taken care of. If your purpose is to gain knowledge, if your purpose is job oriented, if your purpose is to just add another degree, I don't know what your purpose is. So identify the purpose. That is very critical. Once that is identified, then you can take the small steps guided by the faculty, guided by the industry experts, guided by your own experiences in the college, through various activities. Everything takes you towards achieving your goal and towards achieving your purpose. You don't have to look very far. Within the college, you will have so many opportunities to learn, not just in the classroom, even outside the classroom. All the very best. Hope all of you are safe wherever you are. And whenever the college resumes physical classes, I hope you'll have a great time. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you, Group Captain Srikanthji. So nice of you. And sometime, you know, someday all of you will come here, at least take, you can talk to your group here as much as ever. Thank you so much. And sorry for compressing your time. And finally, we have with us our administrator, Sri Rohit Punjaji, the administrator of NITEC group here. Sir, you have been a witness to what's in the campus here. You have been a great supporter from the day one itself. The kind of motivation you've been giving, you know, has really helped the organization to come up to this level here. We are extremely happy and blessed that you are here. Now, may I request you, sir, to give your address. It's a kind of, actually a presidential address, last one. Thank you so much. Please, over to you, sir.
Good afternoon to everybody. I hope I'm audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I'm audible. That's good. Good afternoon once again. I welcome all the dignitaries we have on this virtual session. There are many of them. I welcome each one of them. This session is for our new students. Many of them are on the call with their parents. I welcome the students and the parents. We also have heads of our NITEC colleges, teachers and guests. I welcome to each one of you on this session. I will keep my talk limited to NIT Education Trust, this college, NIT School of Management, and a few words about our employers who employ our students. For the students, we believe, and the parents of students, we believe you have taken an excellent decision to join NIT School of Management. You are now part of the NIT family. You will get to know what it means to be part of the NIT family in your journey next 2 years and beyond that. So welcome to the family. Professor Nagraj and several other speakers have talked to you about how NITE started in 1979, NITE Education Trust, and how it has grown in the 40 years thereafter. NITE Education Trust, I want to spend a few minutes on this to talk about a few points which I think are important. NIT Education Trust in the year 2008 created what is now called NIT University, deemed to be university, which has under its fold many of our health science colleges. So medicine, pharmacy, dental, other such colleges fall under the NIT Education Trust. Many colleges continue to be under, many of these the health sciences fall under NITE University, and there are many colleges that continue to be under the trust. Roughly, the student population is 50% under the university and 50% under the trust, roughly. In all, we have 40 institutions, when you count all of them, which is a large number. In the last 40 years, it has grown from 1 to 40. Our president, Mr. Hegde, president of the trust, is very clear that all our institutes must be colleges of choice for students. So keeping this in mind, that our colleges should be colleges of choice, colleges of preference, our colleges, our teachers, everybody in the NITE community spend a lot of time in working and investing in taking teaching, research, facilities and opportunities for both students and teachers to the next level. That is, there is a constant attempt to improve and further improve and still improve, still more improvement, so that everything gets better, our colleges keep growing, and the experience for the students and the faculty keep improving. Some numbers to share for you, I've seen a few of them in the slide Professor Jairam shared. NITE University for 3 years has been the top 100 in NIRF. In 2020, this year, they were ranked 74. The university is in the Asia, QS Asia ranking number 450 to 500 in that range for colleges and universities in, for universities in Asia. The medical college has consistently outperformed, which is number 36 in NIRF. Dental college is number 5, pharmacy college is 49. And the NITE Meenakshi College next door, a few meters from NSOM, is number 28. These are just a few numbers to show how the colleges are growing and the focus on providing best of class opportunities and teaching for students. Another dimension of NITE University and NITE Education Trust, which Sri Annamalai had many words to talk about, I wish to talk about that a little, and that is NITE community has a very human side to it. In these difficult times, there is no retrenchment, full salaries are being paid. This is a unique aspect of the NITE family and the community. I will ask that students and parents on this call learn and understand this dimension of the trust, embrace it, and work in a manner that works to a positive outcome for you, for the parent, and for the people you work with at NMIT, at NSOM, your teachers, your administrators, and other people that you will work with. I will move on to NSOM as a college within the NITE Education Trust fold. This college is, as you have heard, very very ably guided by Professor Venugopal. There are many teachers on the school, in the school, teaching you, and many of them are on this virtual session, and many of them are still in the industry. So they have one foot in the industry, one foot in academia. What this means for students is that your learning experience is very aligned to what industry wants. Teachers are able to understand the changing demands of the industry and take that learning, that experience, and translate that into the classroom learning or the online learning that you might have. The advisory panel, as you have seen in the slides, is also very rich. Placement opportunities, the courses you have, all of that you have seen in the last few minutes, so I will not elaborate on that. All I will say is that the students of NSOM, new and old, are in very capable and caring hands. Please make the most of this opportunity to advance your professional and personal life. The third point I wish to talk about is the employers. In my role here at NITE Trust, I meet employers all the time, sometimes more than one a week. And certain common themes come in discussions with them. One theme is that we really don't know what job we will have in 5 years. How do they make that statement? They say, for example, and it's very true, that the roles we have today, social media manager, data scientist, digital marketing specialist, cloud services, and people who understand what cloud services mean. These are all roles and jobs that didn't exist 5 years ago and definitely 10 years ago. What will we have in the next 5 years? Who knows? Technology is changing, the world is changing ever so quickly, and you'll probably have a new set of roles that are not in the newspapers today, in the jobs wanted pages. So what do employers want? Since the roles are changing, since the demands are changing, what employers want today and what they will want 5 years from now are some critical skills from students who are in interviews. Some of those skills, not all, some are very good communication skills, ability to think critically, ability to be creative. You will be presented with problems you have not seen, your bosses have not seen, your managers have not seen, because things are changing on a day-to-day basis. Employers are looking for commitment. Employers are looking for professionalism. These are all things that you have to learn, you have to understand, and be able to demonstrate when you enter the workplace and as you continue to be in the workplace. We are moving away from rote learning, so mugging up concepts are no longer the need of the hour. You need to understand the concept you are learning, and you need to understand where they are applied. Interview questions do not say, tell me what is this theory and tell me what is that theory. In fact, interview questions now are, some of them are, what do you think about? So have you been exposed to this idea? Have you read about it? Have you thought about it? Do you have a point of view? Discuss the pluses of A versus B. So this is more complicated. Now you need to know A and B, have thought about it and say which is better under which situation. I've been in an interview with a foreign group, foreign meaning with a group of employers sitting in another country. And one of the questions thrown to the interviewee, the candidate, was, can you estimate the number of window ACs in Bangalore? I'll give you 3 minutes. So this question reflects or shows the thinking capability of the candidate. Can he or she make some assumptions? Can he derive some number? Can he have a ballpark number for estimating windows, AC window, air conditioners in the city of Bangalore? So what are these things? These things are skills. These things are things that can be improved with practice. So if you are a sportsman and you have seen Virat Kohli bat, if you like music and you have seen Zakir Hussain on the tabla, or if you are a footballer and you have seen Messi do a free kick and you have said, wow, it is something these people have learned by practicing for hours across many years. If you do the same thing, whether it is cricket, football, or whether it's critical thinking, you also will be able to excel and perform brilliantly for whatever it is that you've been practicing. My request, therefore, for you is to start early, take help from your teachers, and be better prepared for jobs, for life, both professional and personal, at the time of graduation and thereafter. Don't wait for graduation day or interview day minus 30 days or minus 60 days, because that will be too late. I also wish to talk to you about life at NSOM and all the other institutions today. We are in unusual circumstances, unusual times. With COVID-19, we spend so much of our time indoors. That's been personally true for me. Many aspects of our lives have gone online. The fact that we're having this session with so many people, dignitaries, parents, students, and others online is just one example. I wish to tell you a short story here about what happened last week as far as online learning is concerned. I was in a session, we had many senior teachers, and we had a professor from IIT Mumbai, a professor who has been teaching at IIT since sometime in 1980s. So senior professor, well-established, high degree of subject expertise. This teacher, professor from IIT, had an experiment in the video call. What he did is he said, I'm going to now show you a video of something that I've been talking to you about. Having said that, he turned the video on. What we heard, what we saw as participants in the seminar is somebody speaking in the video, no graphic, no visuals, nothing. Just somebody talking. It was clear that this was a recorded message in the video, but we could not see anything, no movie, no graphic, no nothing. After about 60 seconds, somebody spoke up and said, sir, we cannot see the video. This professor from IIT Bombay said, I'm glad that you are calling me out, because this was an experiment. I wish to illustrate, the point I wish to make here is that when we are teaching online, when we are working online, we need to have the courage to speak, we need to have the courage to maintain open channels of communication. If you do not do that, what is already very difficult, that is teaching online, will become that much more difficult. Please mark my words. I will encourage teachers on this, teachers who will be doing online teaching, teachers who have been doing online teaching, to encourage the students to speak up, to get feedback from students. And I will encourage students to speak up. These are your teachers, no need to be scared of them. Just talk to them and say, sir, I cannot hear. Sir, there's too much echo. Sir, your, or madam, your visuals are not seen. If you keep quiet, then the learning experience online, which is already very difficult, will suddenly become impossible. So I'll request teachers to encourage students to speak up. I'll request students to speak up and to make this learning experience, which is difficult, a little easier, a little more meaningful and useful to everybody participating. I will close by wishing our teachers who will be teaching the new students and the new students the very best for the time that you spend at NSOM. For the students, please understand that all meaningful outcomes, all meaningful successes, a fundamental requirement is hard work on a sustained basis. Both, you have to work hard and you have to sustain it. It's not one night's work, it's not two nights' work, it is sustained. So I ask students to stay committed. I ask them to work hard, be diligent, stay committed, and you will excel and you will outperform. I will close my remarks with that. God bless everybody. All the best.
Thank you, Rohit Punja sir, for that crisp message like a mother of all messages, you know. Thank you so much for the message. I'm sure we have understood the kind of commitment that has been brought in. And thank you so much for being with us and giving this presidential message. And now finally, friends, last but can never be the least, you know, the voice of heart, that is a vote of thanks. And may request Professor Richard to kindly propose a vote of thanks. And one small announcement before she does. For the students, only students here, our orientation program starts from tomorrow itself. Kindly note, tomorrow itself, not any other day, at 10 o'clock. We already sent you the links. Can't be there as in time. Thank you so much. And over to Richard.
Good afternoon. The meaning of karma is in the intention. The intention behind action is what matters. So our intention is to give right knowledge at the right time to the right committed people. Respected Professor Nagaraj Ram Rao, Vice Chancellor, Kalasalingam Academy of Research and Education, Sri Annamalai IPS and Motivational Guru, Sri Vinay Hegde, President of NITTE Education Trust and Chancellor of NITTE University, Professor Dr. N. R. Shetty, Chairman and Mentor, NITTE School of Management, Sri Rohit Punja, Administrator, NITTE Education Trust, Dr. H. C. Nagaraj, Principal, NMIT, students and stakeholders. I, Richa Tiwari, consider a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks to all the dignitaries who have made it convenient to attend NSOM inaugural function in the virtual environment. Today's program was unique and first of its type in this current times of COVID-19 situation, where we are embracing the technology as a whole to transcend education from origin to the destination for the benefit of the society and education. We are deeply grateful to the respected, to Professor Nagaraj Ram Rao, Vice Chancellor, Kalasalingam Academy of Research and Education, for gracing this occasion as a chief guest and for an enlightening address. His address was unique as always because of the novelty of his ideas as well as his style. Sir, I thank you for presiding over this function and your address. I take this opportunity to express our sincere thanks to respected Sri Annamalai IPS and Motivational Guru for youth and for gracing this occasion as the guest of honor. His presence today in this function has immensely enhanced its importance. We are extremely grateful to you, sir, for your insightful address. I must express my deep gratitude to Sri Vinay Hegde, President of NET and Chancellor of NITTE University, for guiding the institute and giving all support for carrying out student developmental activities. I would also give my deep regards to Professor Dr.
NR Shetty for giving unconditional support to run all academic-oriented activities for the benefit of the students at large at every level of interface. I also express my sincere thanks to Sri Rohit Punja, Administrator NET, for giving us timely guidance on various aspects of infrastructure for students' educational flow from institute end to our credible students. I express my deep regards and thanks to our principal, Dr. H.C. Nagraj, for his guidance and support at every step in delivering our services to the students. Lastly, I thank our institute's director, NSOM, Dr. M. Venugopal, for his unconditional support and guidance in these difficult times of pandemics to carry out on our institutional duties without any obstacles. My colleagues and teaching and non-teaching staff for making this program a success. I also thank students and their parents for joining in and taking the right decision for the students' development. Now, I thank each one of you for joining in and joining for the good future. Now we all raise for national anthem.
अधिनायक जय हिंद भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा ग्रामीण बुंदेल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Thank you one and all. I hope everybody keeps themselves safe at their place. God be with you all. And tomorrow all students should join at 10 o'clock because we believe in discipline. So please, all of the students should join at 10 o'clock sharp for the orientation program. Thank you one and all.
Recording.